I'm Brooks Patterson, Oakland County Executive. It is my honor to welcome you to the Arts and Apples Tribute Reception and to introduce the 50th anniversary documentary celebrating the heritage of the Arts and Apples Festival. This documentary features interviews with the founders, artists, and the team at Paint Creek Center for the Arts who continue each year to progress and coordinate this nationally ranked event for our community. Hope you will enjoy the footage, which demonstrates the community ties and the long-standing history of this event.
Rochester, always in the past, has had a lot of artists out here. And in 1961, Oakland University held an art fair, and several friends of ours that we knew called, and they said, I think we could do it. And that was the first gem of the idea.
We had to lay all the groundwork and get all the ideas for the festival. And our goal was to have this a community-wide effort. And the whole community took part in putting this festival together.
Weekend after Labor Day each year brings on the Art and Apples Festival, a three-day event that transforms the 30-acre Rochester Municipal Park into one of the nation's highest-ranked art fairs.
You know, when you look statewide, we're pretty excited to be pretty prominent in not only the state of Michigan, but nationally.
The Art and Apples Festival is Michigan's second largest juried art fair, bringing in over 290 fine artists from across the country. The festival also ranks as one of the best reviewed fine arts and design shows in Sunshine Artist Magazine, a leading publication for art and craft show exhibitors and patrons.
50 years is a long time for any tradition, but having something like Art and Apples stay the same but evolve as a festival is a wonderful testament to its success and to our community.
For half a century, the Art and Apples Festival has featured a continuously changing array of artists, vendors, and culinary treats, while also respecting beloved traditions like apple pies, marching bands, dance groups, and the inclusion of artists who have displayed their work at the festival since 1965.
In 1965, they said they need artists for a show they're planning.
Rochester was a very different town in those days. You walked downtown, you knew everybody. And so a group of us had this dream of doing an art festival.
And then two people approached us, Beth Hoheisel, who was the art teacher at Rochester High, and Gene Saley, who was with then the Pontiac Press. And they came to the two of us and they said, we're happy to help, but we don't want to chair it. Nobody wanted to chair it, see. So that's how we became involved.
And one of the first obstacles we had to overcome was getting permission from the village fathers to be able to have the festival on the park grounds.
There's a picture of him with a lawnmower cutting the grass up there because he was trying to tell the council there's space to do this.
And they said, well, you don't have any bridge or anything to get there. Well, Dick Don, who was the city manager at the time, he put a bridge across there, and that was great.
Yeah, and gave them the bill.
You're right.
It was done, period.
Right. Then I got a phone call down the road. Would you mind coming down and give us a hand? We need help. I did that for the next 21 years. So, anyway, the first Art and Apples was all done in circus tents.
See, we had to set up art galleries in every single tent. The individual chairman of each tent decided how the arrangement was going to be inside. And we also had a very good jury.
And that's how it all began. I chose the judges for the first show, the first professional painters.
The fair is difficult to put on because you need so many volunteers. It was labor intensive.
Some of the major credits have to go to the JCs, who did all the manual labor on it, and the Kiwanis, who did all the electrical. And next question is, well, how did we raise money for it? Well, we had a community patronage drive, and then I beat the pavement for several months to get advertising for our first program. Another major obstacle was the weather.
Sonny Elliott, who was the weatherman at that time, had predicted terrible weather for those 4 days.
We only had, I think, 900 people on the first day, which was a Thursday, because we had it for 4 days. And the next day, the weather got a little bit better, and we had a couple thousand,
yeah,
I think.
2000.
And then it was miraculous that the next 2 days were fantastic.
Yeah, it went hot.
So we drew well over 20,000 people to attend
total.
The first show.
It put it on the map.
Barb and I went back to the City Fathers again, and I said, you know, we're going to continue this on. They agreed to that, and I said, the other thing I'd like you to do is form an arts commission.
Yeah.
And so we were named the chairman of the first arts commission established by the Village of Rochester.
The Art and Apples Festival is organized by the Paint Creek Center for the Arts, a regional nonprofit arts center located in Rochester.
Each year, we bring 200,000 people to downtown Rochester, and now that it's ranked nationally, we have recognition and are bringing in artists from all over, not just the country, but now all over the world. So that's pretty exciting for a small six-person nonprofit organization.
Oh, back in 82, Avon Township turned into Rochester Hills, and this building sat empty. And we said, we ought to get our hands on it. And I was part of the crew went over for the acceptance, and they sold the building to us for a dollar. Once we got to Paint Creek Center of the Art, it gave us a goal for the money we made off Art and Apples.
The festival is one of our most important programs that we have, so the board gets really involved along with the staff. It's such a big combination of everybody, the community, the leaders that are in the organization, and really a lot of volunteers to really put the whole thing together. It really takes a village to do that.
We sit down with the committee, and it's an exciting time for us to be able to see how we can be innovative in the festival. So we're really excited to be bringing the best artists into our region.
In Rochester, I think we have certain expectations for the community. We have the expectation of having good schools, having a safe community, but I also think there is that ability to have creative outlets and have these attributes in our community, like an art center. The center itself really couldn't go on without the Art and Apples Festival. It provides 80% of our operating revenue each year to help the center go, for us to provide art classes to the community and to provide the art market and all of our exhibitions that we have each year.
I think it makes a statement about the community, about the quality of life in that community. Yeah, as a county executive, of course, I'm always involved in budgets and so, but there's another half of the ledger. That's what we're talking about. It's the quality of life. What makes it unique and fun to live here, raise your family, and have your kids throw around in a safe environment? Something like Arts and Apples fits the bill.
It's very important that Rochester and North Oakland County have that kind of a juried professional art show. It brings a cultural depth to our community.
About 3 years ago, we had this terrible rainstorm. The vendors had gone home. It was a Saturday afternoon. And so one of the other board members and I were making our round, and there's these ducks that were wandering through the Art and Apples Festival, and pretty much the park was empty. The next day, Sunday, it was so beautiful, we couldn't get people out of the park, but it was just so strange to be from nothing to where it was the next day.
We pulled the Boy Scouts in at the very end because we had to have someone to park cars. We had no idea how many people would show up.
You kind of evolve with this, and every year the fair, I just haven't missed one. Art and Apples, to me, it just evolved down to today to where Home Sweet Home is the best fair.
We worked hard, but we were all young couples then with young children, and I stayed with them for 25 years, and then I could see other young people were coming in and ready to take on the job.
I grew up in Rochester, and I've been coming to Art and Apples festivals, you know, my whole life. I remember very vividly coming with my father. It's always been something I remember fondly. In addition, my wife was the festival director for 3 years. It really was a lot of fun for her and I and our whole family.
I started off at a very young age as a part of this whole process, and I do recall a lot of apple pies and a lot of apple cider. And Rochester is a small community, but it has a big heart when it comes to arts. And I think it's just good to encourage generations to come to be involved. And I think it's a great tradition to have.
We've been at it a long time.
And more to come.
it's obviously started in this apple orchard town. And it's wonderful to meet Mr. and Mrs. Sulverson, who established the Art in Apples Festival. And hearing them and the passion that they had, I take that as a really important job to continue the legacy that they started and continue it 50 years into the future and beyond.
This festival has carried on for so many years
yeah.
and been so successful. So we're very proud of that it continued on.